A very good morning, dear students. The Panchayati Raj chapter, we studied, what and all we studied was how the local government at the village level is going to work for the well-being of the people at the village level. We saw levels of local government, that is Panchayati Raj. Under Panchayati Raj, we have three levels of government: Gram Panchayat, Panchayati Samiti or Janpad Panchayat, and District Panchayat or Zilla Panchayat Parishad. The Gram Panchayat works at the grassroots level of the village level. And we also saw the Gram Panchayat consists of Gram Sabha and Gram Panchayat and Nyaya Panchayat. So Gram Sabha, what it consists of, how it is made? It consists of the members who have completed 18 years of age of men and women, and who live in that particular area. And we also saw the functions of Gram Sabha. Mainly it elects the members of Gram Panchayati. Its work is to what? To elect the members of the Gram Panchayat, discuss the problems of the requirements of the village, and getting approval sanction from the developmental activities, and getting approval for the plans, and keeping in front of the DC, and they monitor, they administrate the activities of Gram Panchayat, and they will look after all the financial resources properly, and they will work for the with collaboration of people of all the members of the Gram Panchayat. Next, we also saw Gram Panchayat and its composition. Gram Panch consists of members who are elected by the Gram Sabha, and it consists of going to be worked for one village or two or more small villages together. Composition: Gram Panchayat consists of Sarpanch, elected members by the Gram Sabha, and Panchayati Secretary. In that, 1/3 seats will be allotted for the women, and it also includes scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. And how many years it is going to be worked? For 5 years. And dear students, who is a Sarpanch and Panch? Every villages will be divided into small areas, and each these areas is known as wards. And the person who is elected to look after these wards will be called as Panch, and he will be guided under the guidance of the Sarpanch. Below the Sarpanch is going to work out for the well-being of these wards. Panch will be worked under the Sarpanch. So Sarpanch will be the head of the all the Panchs who will be allotted for the ward improvement. So next comes the Panchayati Secretary. The Panchayat Secretary will be appointed by the government officials, and he will be responsible for what? She who acts as a Panchayat Secretary will be responsible for calling the or making arrangements for the meetings. And before that, they will have a discussion with the village members about as to what to discuss, what are the problems they are facing. And they will note down, and one day they will fix the date and day and the place to have a meeting. And what are the proceedings, whatever the suggestion or the discussion they have made in the meetings, they will be recorded in a document, in a paper, in a file. They will be kept, and it is going to be kept in front of the higher authorities to get approval. By that, they will have a budget and estimation of the financial requirement of the budget. And they will going to, again, they will disclose this matter, or they will discuss this matter with the village members, like maybe education matter, farming, health, etc. Next, what are the functions of the Gram Panchayat is going to be, how it is going to be function, works? Main activities or the work or responsibility is construction and maintenance of public facilities, basic needs of the village members. Then provision of education, providing educational facilities, healthcare facility, dispensary, I said, it's a medical center which is going to provide the medicines. Then construction and maintenance of water sources. Basically, villages depends upon agriculture as their main occupation. So agriculture requires water. Water sources are what? Wells, hand pumps, lakes. All these should be kept clean, and they should have more in number in order to have a water resources, sources for the growth of crops. Then they will collect the taxes from where? From on houses, shops and land also. They will record the birth and death rates of that particular village. And they will also implement the employment schemes provided by the government. And they will give cleanliness and hygiene in the villages, how to keep themselves clean and their surroundings in order to avoid the pollution and the diseases arising, and all this knowledge they will be given to the people. Then prevention of practices like caste discrimination and the gender-based discrimination.